Okay, good afternoon all. This is Dr. Mahesh M. Vanjeri, Assistant Professor, Department of Management Studies, SDM College of Engineering and Technology, Dharwad. This class is conducted for MBA semester for marketing students in the subject Sales Force Management. So today we are going to learn from Unit 4, Chapter Number 9, Sales Force Compensation. So I'd like just like to give a brief background of what we have learned so far. So this subject deals with the managing the sales representatives or managing the sales force of an organization. So the basic functions include like recruitment and selection, training, motivation, compensation, leadership, performance appraisal. Okay. So in this part of the chapter, we are going to learn. So how an organization, how a company designs a compensation package or salary. So students are very eager, new recruits are very eager. Okay. So every time they want to apply for a company, the first thing they want to know is what is the compensation. So we'll have a in-depth discussion on how organizations design a compensation package. Okay. So before we begin, so there is a quote here by Ovid. How little you know about the age you live in. If you fancy that honey is sweeter than cash in hand. Okay. So basically he's talking about the innocence. Okay. Of the person who doesn't know what money can buy or how much money is important. So definitely for sales representatives also, money is important, which they get in the form of compensation or salary. Okay. So Ovid was a Roman poet, ancient one. Okay. So you can know more about him. Okay. From Google. Okay. So before we begin, so just like I would like to share a small joke on compensation of sales reps in India. So when I was working as a sales rep, okay, salaries were not quite higher. Okay. So bachelors or singles, okay, sales reps living in a rented house or in a rented room, okay, and trying to manage their expenses within the salary. Okay. So it is on that. So it is in Hindi. So dates, the first what I'm going to tell, the numbers are dates of a month. Ek se das means 1 to 10th of a month. Das se 20 means 11th to 20th of the same month. Bees se 30 means 20th to 30th of the same month. So what is the financial condition of a sales rep? So ek se 10 garam. Garam means salary is credited. Okay, so he has full of money. Okay, so we say ek se 10 garam, from date 1 to date 10th garam. 10 se 20 naram. Naram means softer. Because on receipt of the salary, okay, he would have paid the house rent or room rent, mess bill, okay, then fuel for the vehicle, mobile phone recharge, sending some money to family or saving something in the savings bank account. So very little money has left. So we say, thus say bees naram. Then bees say tees besharam. Okay. It means all the money is exhausted. So he will go to friends and ask for a credit. Okay, give me 500 rupees. I'll return it in next month. Give me 1000 rupees. Okay. So I hope most of your salaries are very good. So you won't land into that trouble. Okay. So with that brief joke, so we'll make a beginning to Salesforce compensation. Let us learn, okay, how organizations design compensation. So most of you have received your offer letter. So it should be easy for you to understand the structure of compensation. So first part we are going to learn from figure 9.1, what a good sales compensation plan should do. Okay. So compensation plans are designed keeping in some objectives in mind. Okay. So when a company designs a compensation package, okay, it has some objectives in mind. So generally a company will design a compensation plan, okay, who should, okay, reward the employees. Okay, but not simply reward, reward their efforts plus results, so that the compensation package should be a rewarding one to the sales reps, okay, which motivates the sales reps to put more efforts. So I'll give an example. If I give you two types of salaries, one is only a company paying only fixed salary irrespective of the achievement of the sales targets, another company paying fixed part salary plus commission on the over and above the sales achieved, sales quota or sales targets. So in first case, the sales rep knows whether he achieved the targets or not, he is going to get a fixed sum of money every month. But in the second company, so the sales reps understand that along with the fixed amount, if they sell more than target, they are going to get some additional money in the form of commission. So that is how we say the compensation plan should be rewarding. In case of second company, the compensation plan is rewarding in nature. It enables or motivates the sales reps to put more efforts. The compensation plan. Okay, a good compensation plan should control activities of sales reps. Okay, so the compensation plan. Okay, so whatever the sales reps are doing, let's say if it is about expense account or bills of expenses when they submit at the end of the month. Okay, so the compensation plan should be designed in a way where the activities of the sales rep can be kept under certain control. And treat customers properly. Okay, the compensation, if the compensation plan is good, it is like company respecting the sales reps. In turn, it will motivate the sales reps to treat customers properly. Okay, so if the company incorporates an element of customer feedback, okay, in the monthly appraisal, and if that monthly appraisal is okay related to the commission part, okay, so in that way that compensation plan will enable the sales reps to treat customers properly. Attract and keep good people. So good people, when I say good recruits, good sales representatives, the compensation plan, okay, usually when we see, so a market leader, when he goes for recruitment, the number of applications will be usually very high. There are two reasons. One, definitely the company is largest in the industry. The second reason, equally important, is generally the pay package or the compensation package will be highest. So the companies that pay a very attractive salary, very high salary, they attract and keep good talent. So that is the way how a compensation plan should be designed. Then economical yet competitive. So when I say the company should pay a higher salary, that does not mean it should pay unreasonably high. Okay, it should not, a company cannot afford to pay unreasonably higher salaries. Okay, that's why it is said the salary should be, a good compensation plan is economical. Okay, economical, when we say it is appropriately paid, in proportion, it is paid in proportion to the efforts of the sales reps, but yet, okay, so it is a competitive in the industry, so that the good talent is still attracted towards the company. Flexible and stable. A good compensation plan or a good sales compensation plan should be flexible as well as stable. So stable, when you say the compensation policy should be stable and the package should be flexible. So as and when the sales reps achieve their sales targets, okay, beyond the sales targets, okay, the company should be in a position to pay the commissions as per the policy. So that is what we say flexibility. And as and when the sales reps move to different towns, okay, from tier one town to tier two town to state capitals, metros, where the cost of living will be very higher. Okay, so if you remember one of the companies that came for campus recruitment, so how they mentioned in Bombay and Bangalore, the compensation package was higher, and in other cities, the compensation package was lower. So that is what we say, flexible. It should be simple and easy to understand for a sales rep. He should know at the end of the month how much he is going to take home. It should be fair. Okay, company should not involve into any unethical practices. Okay, so it should provide job security as well as incentive to the sales rep. A good sales compensation plan is one that provides security to the employees as well as incentive to the sales reps. And last but not the least, okay, a good sales compensation plan is one, so which motivates the salesperson. So if you remember the previous chapter, we learned about the motivational mix. They are broadly classified into financial and non-financial. So financial elements of motivation mix are one among the most important, okay, with respect to motivating the sales representatives. So this is the first part, okay. So when a company designs a compensation structure, they should keep these things in mind. Second part, steps in designing a sales compensation plan. So as I initially mentioned, so this topic deals with, okay, understanding how a company designs a compensation plan. So it begins with the review of job description. Okay, so what are the job responsibilities? Higher the job responsibilities, can be understood that higher will be the salary. Lower the job responsibilities, lower will be the salary. So in that case, so that is the reason why a company should review the job description first. Then identify the plan's objective. So previously we saw what a good compensation plan should do. Okay, so what is the objective of your company compensation plan? Okay, so those objectives have to be specifically identified. Then based on that, establish a level of compensation. Definitely how much has to be paid. Then pretest and install plan. Okay, so this can be done using simulation. Okay, or a sample survey can be done of the compensation plan before it is implemented. Then decide on indirect monetary compensation, so which are called as the fringe benefits. Okay, then develop the method of compensation. Okay, so sorry, we have to come this way. Establish level of compensation. After that, develop the method of compensation. So we learn whether salary, straight salary, or salary plus commission, or salary plus commission plus bonus. So we'll learn more about the method of compensation. Decide on indirect monetary compensation, that is what is paid, okay, as a fringe benefit to the employees. Then pretest the plan and implement the compensation plan or pay salary according to the plan. So these are the steps involved in designing sales compensation plan. Okay. And then, so these are the building blocks for a sales compensation plan. So when I say develop method of compensation, so building blocks for a sales compensation plan. So what objectives? Okay. So what objectives each component of the salary basically serve? Which objective they meet? So if you look at the salary part, which is the fixed component, salary is the fixed component in the compensation plan. It provides a security. So the sales rep is ensured, the sales representative is ensured of certain minimum salary irrespective of the achievement of the target. So salary component in the compensation plan is a fixed part. It is a fixed component. You will get it irrespective of the achievement of target. So objective of this component of the compensation is to provide security to the sales reps. So provide some minimum level of, okay, income to the sales reps. The second component of the compensation plan is incentives. Okay, so incentives are of different forms. One is a commission, so generally paid for overachieving the sales targets. If you achieve anything above the sales targets, so you will get the commission. Bonus is annual payment, which is paid as a percentage of the annual salary. Generally, commission is individual based and the bonus is a team based, or a profit sharing. So in some cases, companies may decide to share profit with their employees. So these all are incentives. So these are variable part of the compensation plan. So profit sharing, bonus or commission totally depends on the performance of individual sales representatives. Hence, they act as incentive for better performance. So this enables the sales reps to put more efforts. Then benefits. So third component of the compensation plan is benefits. So this is what we call decide on indirect monetary compensation. This is indirect monetary compensation, paid vacation, insurance. So some of you who have received your offer letters, you can check for this, what is there as a benefit. Paid vacation, insurance, moving expenses. If you are transferred from one place to another place, company will reimburse the expenses. Pension, not applicable to all companies. Profit sharing, So profit sharing can be either incentive or a benefit. And any other, it depends on companies. The fourth component of the compensation plan is expenses. So since sales reps will be traveling extensively, their traveling expenses have to be reimbursed by the company. So hence it become cost component and part of your compensation plan. So the expenses that are reimbursed by the company are travel, lodging when you go outstation, company car if the company has provided the car, or if we sometimes the sales rep may own a car and the company will bear the repair and maintenance expenses. They will pay for the fuel, insurance, etc. Entertainment, so these are not provided by all the companies. So very few companies provide these kind of expenses, but definitely yes, travel, lodging and fuel expenses for two wheelers, mobile phone, these expenses are paid by the company to sales reps. So these are the building blocks for a sales compensation plan. It means these components, security, incentives, benefits and expenses are incorporated in developing a sales compensation plan. So if you can recall your compensation, those who have received offer letters, they include, so any, these all four or any three of, these building blocks. That is how your cost to company or compensation plan is designed. So this is mentioned once again, salary. Salary is a direct monetary reward paid for performing certain duties over a period of time. So salary is a fixed component in the pay plan or compensation plan. A salary is a direct monetary reward paid. A salary is a direct monetary reward paid for performing certain duties over a period of time. So when you work, in your compensation plan or offer letter, there is a fixed component that you will get irrespective of whatever amount of effort you are putting. The amount of payment is related to a unit of time rather than the work accomplished. So that fixed component or salary is paid for a unit of time, means for usually 1 month or 30 days. It is not paid for the work accomplished, because anyway you will get, as I said, whether you achieve your sales target or not. A salary is a fixed element in a pay plan. So I hope the concept is more clear. And if you can recall your offer letter, compensation plan mentioned therein, it will become more easy for you to understand. Commission is a regular payment for the performance of a unit of work. So a commission is related to a unit of accomplishment or achievement, in contrast to the salary method, which is a fixed payment for a unit of time. So though it is paid regularly, but the component amount is not fixed. It is a variable. It varies according to your performance. So before we move on to the method of compensation. So steps in designing sales compensation. So far what we learned, review the job description, identify plans, objectives, establish level of compensation. So now we'll move on to next part, that is develop the method of compensation. So before that, I will take a break. And if you have any queries, you can ask. I'm going to unmute your audio.
Last.
Yes, Krishna Kant, any questions?
No, sir.
Whether my voice was clear?
Yes, sir.
Ajit, any questions?
No, sir.
Manjunath, any questions? Manjunath, can you hear me? Sachin Ganji, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Any questions?
No, sir.
Okay, good then. So if no questions, then I'll move on to the remaining part. Okay, so now we are moving on to the fourth step in designing a compensation plan. It is the method of compensation. So there are three methods: straight salary, straight commission, and bonus. And what are the advantages and disadvantages, and where they are best used? Okay, so we are going to learn. Okay, the first method is straight salary. So let us consider the advantages first. Provide security and stability for sales representatives. Okay, so as straight salary method provides security, so the some minimum amount of income will is assured for the sales reps every month through straight salary method. So therefore, the turnover or attrition of the sales reps can be reduced here. That is the advantage. It is better for directing and controlling sales activities and ensures proper treatment for customers. Okay, so provided there is professional environment, okay, among the organizations, as well as the sales reps all are professionals. Direct disadvantage of the straight salary method is direct incentive is easily lost if not administered properly. So since all the sales reps get the fixed component, straight salary only, those sales reps who perform better than others, okay, so they will not get the direct incentive and it will be lost. Okay, so definitely it demotivates those sales reps who perform better than others. And sales represents a fixed cost. Since straight salary is a fixed component, okay, it represents a fixed cost in the cost structure. The third disadvantage of straight salary method is requires supervision to direct control and evaluate the sales reps, because anyway the sales salary will be credited to the account. Okay, so sales reps may not work effectively, okay, without the supervision. So therefore, supervision is required to direct control and evaluate the sales representatives. So where straight salary method is best used? Okay, for which type of products or in which cases? Straight salary method is best used for products that require a lot of pre-sale and or post-sale service. Okay, so many a case in case of industrial products, a lot of industrial products. Okay, they require pre-sale and post-sale services. Okay, so in such a case, straight salary method is recommended. Okay, the cases where building long-term customer relationships are required, again, it is in case of industrial marketing or business marketing, where building long-term customer relationship is important, straight salary method can be used. Okay, as it ensures proper treatment to customers. When supervision is available for new recruits, it can be done, okay, because we don't know what is the potential of a new territory. So while placing a new rep in a new territory, the company initially can pay straight salary. Or for missionary sales means where only promotion is involved and selling is not involved. If you remember my example, okay, I worked in pharmaceutical marketing, okay, and my customers were doctors, okay, but doctors did not purchase, doctors did not purchase my medicines, they prescribed my medicines. So I only used to remind and promote the products to doctors. So in such case, straight salary method can be used. Students pay attention. See, only for the learning purpose. Okay, so we are learning them separately, like straight salary method, straight commission method, and bonus method. Okay, generally what we find is a combination of a salary plus commission or salary plus commission plus bonus. That is how even your compensation plan is designed if you refer your offer letters. But for the understanding purpose, we have split them into three and learning about them separately. So I hope the information is clear and loud. The second method of compensation is a straight commission. But here definitely I can give you example of straight commission. If you know LIC, Life Insurance Corporation of India, it's insurance agents, LIC agents, okay, are paid only straight commission. They don't get straight salary. They only get the variable pay, which is straight commission. So whatever premium is collected on that certain percentage, they get as commission. So LIC is using straight commission method of compensation for its insurance agents. So what are the advantages of a straight commission plan? Provides a strong incentive. So it is simple. So if the LIC agents collect premium in a particular month, they earn commission. If they don't collect premium, they don't earn anything. So straight commission method provides a strong incentive. Salespeople have more freedom since there is no fixed component of salary. Okay, so salespeople are more free, and it acts as a screening method also, whom the company wants to consider for further positions. Then the disadvantage of straight commission includes difficult to direct and supervise salespeople, as salespeople have more freedom. They have more freedom because they don't get any fixed salary. They are paid only commission. Customers' best interests may be ignored. Okay. For example, an insurance agent who is paid only commission, he may try to push and promote those policies where the percentage of commission is higher. He may not consider the customer needs. Salespeople's earnings may fluctuate widely. Definitely that does happen in case of a LIC agent. Okay, his or her earnings are widely fluctuate from month to month depending on the premium collection. And where straight commission method can be used directly, and a strong incentive is needed to attain sales. For example, if LIC agents, or for that matter any insurance company agents, left alone, okay, they won't sell enough. So the strong incentive is definitely required in achieving sales. For products that require little pre-sale or post-sale service, the sale is a one-time sale. Okay, so in such case, only straight commission can be used. Okay, so if you can recall those small sales organizations whose sales reps come to sell some dictionaries, bulbs, okay, incense sticks, okay, and floor cleaning agents, if you can recall. Okay, so those products when they sell, that is only one time sale. Okay, so these sales reps basically work only on straight commission. Adequate field supervision is not available. Small rep firms, enough supervision is not available. So definitely smaller firms pay only commission. Company is in a weak financial position, or company uses part-time or independent sales people. Under these circumstances, straight commission method can be used. So I will end today's class with the last method of compensation, bonus. Okay, so bonus, 1 minute. Okay, so bonus is, a certain percentage of the annual salary of a sales rep. I repeat, bonus is paid as certain percentage of the annual salary of a sales rep. Okay, so bonus payment of bonus is not compulsory. Okay, so the advantages of bonus include added incentive. Along with the commission, bonus is an added incentive and increases the satisfaction of the sales reps further. It motivates the sales reps further. Bonus can be used for specific activities. Okay, for example, team selling. It is flexible as payment of bonus is not compulsory. What are the disadvantage? Payment of bonus is an added cost to the company. As it is not compulsory to pay, but still if the company wants to pay, it is an added cost. It may be seen as inequitable if not administered properly. Okay, so since it is a certain percentage of the annual salary, so sales reps may get a different amount. So that's why it may be considered as inequitable, as it may be considered as discriminating if not administered properly. Then where it is used? Best used to encourage above normal performance of specific activities. Say for example, if commission is paid on certain achievement of certain percentage of the sales. So if the company wants the sales rep to put efforts beyond that level, they can announce bonus. So let's say for example, 120% and above commissions are paid on achievement of 100% of the sales target. And the company may declare that if the sales reps can achieve 120% and beyond sales target, bonus can be declared. So bonus is usually declared to encourage above normal performance of specific activities. Okay, so here I will stop for the day. Okay, and still I have 4 minutes to go. So I'm going to unmute your audio. If you have any questions, please ask. Before I unmute you, please remember, so generally companies pay a combination of these methods like straight salary plus commission or straight salary plus commission plus bonus in this manner. Okay, so only insurance agents are paid straight commission. Okay, any questions from any students? Okay, can any student exactly, can you recall the compensation plan from your offer letters? Like how much is fixed component, how much is variable, which expenses are reimbursed. Do not disclose name of the company. You can only read the salary part. Do not disclose name of the company. Can anyone do it? Okay. Any questions from students? Hey, Samir Umar ji, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Any questions?
No, sir.
Okay. Santosh, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Any questions?
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay, Sushmita Pawar, hear me.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Any questions?
No, sir.
Okay, then. I hope the concepts are clear. And on Tuesday, I will continue with the chapter and I will conclude the chapter on Tuesday. Okay, so I remind you again and I request you, all those students who have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the notification bell icon, okay, to receive notifications of new videos uploaded. And kindly inform those students who are absent, they can watch and download the video from my YouTube channel. And if you have any questions later also, please remember to call me and thank you for your participation. Okay, I will upload both the videos of today by tonight. Okay, thank you one and all.
Yes, sir.
Bye bye.
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 Yeah, bye bye everyone. Bye.